Tarakan accelerates towards better connectivity. He inherited empty state coffers as his predecessor allegedly splurged public money and encouraged an administrative culture that only practiced compulsive corruption. Tarvinder Singh Rao's last 10 months as the Uttarakhand chief minister hasn't been an easy one. The centimeters, who completed 10 months in the hot seat on January 12, has realized that better connectivity, high investments, jobs to his unemployed youth and less windows to get official files cleared are immediate priorities. In an exclusive chat with Mail Today, Tarvinder Rao, who appeared to have settled now in the hot seat with his trusted set of officers, speaks out his mind on what can move his hill state in high speed. For me, better connectivity between Delhi and Dehradun, which will not only boost local tourism as it is big employment generator, it will also bring in investors. Today I have got 20 flights from Dehradun, have more rail links coming up, and by June to October there will be two main highway links, one being Delhi Haridwar Dehradun and another Delhi Roorkee Dehradun, also getting operational. He told Mail Today, at a time when states are wooing big investors and planning investors summit, Rao's Uttarakhand to is planning one in September. He says, we are looking at big investments but done smartly. We have a big handicap in lack of large tracts of lands to offer to any investor. We have cheapest power in the country, and in ease of doing business we have jumped from 21st position to the 9th spot, and among the hill states Uttarakhand is on top position. We need smart investors who can't generate jobs and boost economic growth while overcoming land crunch issues. Rao's state has just 13% area under agriculture and nearly 71% under forest cover, highest in the country, but he is trying to beat the land crunch hurdle by starting clusters wherein 100150 women can work in each cluster, and has proposed to develop 670 NIA Panchayats, group of Panchayats, as future growth centers around small townships. He sees a direct challenge in current state of health and education sectors, as these two have been negative growth indicators so far. Says Rao, we had no ICUs in our district centers. I have now started the process, and soon we will have about 15 in 13 districts. Foreign collaborations are also being worked out in sharing of technology and equipment in augmenting healthcare in Uttarakhand. We will appoint nearly 1,600 doctors in our hospitals and other healthcare centers by March to boost the state's own health manpower. Uttarakhand has put a mandatory condition for all medical students passing out of state colleges to serve in the state for at least 3 years or else pay grave accent 1 crore to end the bond. Rao says, we have another challenge in finding suitable jobs for our youth. Nearly 5 lakh are in the unemployed list, and we have set a target to employ nearly 1 lakh by 2020. He minces no words that state has encouraged a culture of corruption which derail development even in the name of centimeter funds for public use. Nearly Rs 104 crore were allocated last year, which I had cut down to nearly Rs 25 crore this year, and that to with a condition to show in writing on the use of that money. Same is for simple schemes like plantation. I want to know how many trees are actually planted and how many actually survived in 1 year. These are small measures to cultivate a culture of transparency, he said. Rao said that he has also started a Mananidhi police station fund of Rs 3 crore for some of police station activities out of official call, for which they should not extort or ask for bribe from locals or even the victim or accused in any case.